people becoming more empowered, more aware of their rights and raising their voice in so many parts of the world, the reaction from governments has been quite shocking. Increased repression, attack on human rights defenders, attack on journalists, attack on free speech. What we're seeing across the world in the last few years is a sort of pullback from human rights, which had been taken for granted even in places like Europe. The scale is just staggering. You know, 60 million people displaced, 20 million plus refugees. It's never happened since the Second World War. The problem is not a lack of clarity on what needs to be done. It's a lack of willingness to do it from the leadership in the world. 1.2 million people urgently need resettlement. Not even 10% has come forth so far. Very few countries have signed the Refugee Convention. If you don't have safe and legal routes for refugees to move, we don't recognize that they have international legal protection. Well, that's why we had 4,500 plus people drowning in the Mediterranean Sea, completely preventable deaths. Amnesty International also puts public pressure. We have media, we have campaigning on these issues, and on the ground we collect primary evidence of atrocities, of human rights abuses, and we talk to corporations, we talk to governments about what the impact of their misdeeds are. Everybody predicted what was going to happen in Syria. Today as we speak, this is the tragedy, and we're not acting quickly enough.